Governor Chafee, you've attacked Secretary Clinton for being too close to Wall Street banks. In 1999, you voted for the very bill that made banks bigger.
The Glass-Steagall was my very first vote. I just arrived. My dad had died in office. I was appointed to the office. It was my very first vote.
Are you saying, what does that say about you, that you're casting a vote for something you weren't really sure about?
I think you're being a little rough. I just arrived at the United States Senate.
Coming to you once again from Washington, D.C., where the entire town is still buzzing about not only just who won, but how they won, what they said, how they said it, what their body language was saying. I mean, let's face it. This is the television era. How you looked in front of the camera, it really tells about your electability. So let's discuss just that. Let's welcome in political psychologist Dr. Bart Rossi joins us right now here on the Hardline. All right, Dr. Bart, you had a chance to look at everybody. A lot of smiles, a lot of TV language, a lot of body language going on. You would have to agree, though, that this was Hillary Clinton in a runaway, yes?
Yes, in a runaway because she was very comfortable being herself. She was consistent, surprisingly consistent. I thought she projected herself very well with a winning personality, confident, and she looked good. She looked like she was actually having fun on stage and presenting her views and what she wanted to say and how she wanted to say it. Quite frankly, I thought she was quite brilliant in how she projected herself.
Is it not fair to say that when you get into this kind of a setting and the first Democratic debate, as I mentioned, it's not really always about what you say. It's not about policy. It's how you look. You've got to look clean, crisp, and confident. She's had a lot of experience doing that. So would you agree that I think Martin O'Malley might have come in second in that stead, even though Bernie Sanders was undoubtedly second place in the overall win? How's that?
Well, I think O'Malley did project himself well at times. What he said sometimes was a little bit shaky, but if you noticed his body language, he turned, he looked at Hillary, he seemed to know how to act on stage, and you're right, I think he did project himself well at times during the debate. However, I thought that Bernie Sanders was more dynamic. I mean, he had a message, and he presented that message in a dynamic fashion, which I thought won a lot of people over. I think he looked good as well. Those two probably came in next to Clinton, who, again, projected herself as somebody who was real, authentic, and not a phony, actually a person who really liked being up there.
I got about 30, 40 seconds left here, Dr. Bart. So is it fair to say that when we talk about those three names, Bernie Sanders, Hillary Clinton, Martin O'Malley, the other two, you kind of, even the public goes, who?
Right. I was an analyst for the New York Daily News last night, and I had Chafee finishing last, and obviously Clinton first, and Bernie and O'Malley, I thought, did a pretty good job at projecting themselves. Although I thought the winningest personality was Hillary and how she projected herself and her thoughts.
20 seconds left, though. Did Bernie Sanders make a mistake in giving Hillary chops and actually being nice to her in a couple of instances?
No. I think he projected himself well in doing that because he wants to project to people who think he's authentic and believable. And in doing that, he enhanced himself. He didn't put himself down. He actually enhanced his own image.
And here we go now. This is only the first. Dr. Bart Rossi, always a pleasure. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm sure we're going to talk again. And that will do it then for this edition from Washington, D.C., because as while everybody's talking about it, remember, it's not always how you feel, but it's how you look. Rock on, true believers. See you tomorrow night, right back here on The Hardline.